Let's get ready to praise and worship. Let's get into his spirit. Let's lift up our hands where we are. Let's wave side to side. Let's just put a smile on our face and set the atmosphere where you are. Hallelujah. Let's just ask for God to send his anointing. Hallelujah. Let's ask God to fill us. Hallelujah. Fill us with it. Allow us to praise and worship you because that's why we were created. Amen. Allow the anointing to fall on our pastor as he breaks open the word of God. Allow the anointing to fall on our musicians and our praise and worship team. Allow the anointing to fall on our CBC members, wherever they may be. Allow the anointing to fall on the finances of this church. Hallelujah. Allow every need to be supplied. Hallelujah. Send the increase and the rain, oh God, even in this time. We ask for you to send the rain and to send the increase. We say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. Amen.
We're grateful today. Thank you, praise and worship team. Thank you for setting the atmosphere. We thank God for our musicians, Minister of Music, John Alcara, the drummer man, Mr. Eric Bain, and our technician, Reverend Sherrod Graham, and our entire praise team, Brother Darren, Bishop, Tyra, Nadine, and Sharita. We thank God for them for setting the tone for praise and for worship and for the opportunity to hear from heaven this morning. We thank God for each and every one of you. Come on, let's go to the throne of grace and prayer. Our Father and our God, it is once again, O Lord, that we have come into your presence with thanksgiving. God, we thank you. We thank you, O God, just for being God. We thank you because you touched us with your finger of love this morning and told us to arise and run on and see what the end is going to be. Provided us with a day that we've never seen nor witnessed before. You, O God, looked at us and provided us with brand new mercies. Mercies we don't even deserve. But because you are who you are, God, because you're the Alpha and the Omega, you're the beginning and you're the end. Because, oh God, you're Jehovah Rapha, the God that heals. Because, oh God, you're Jehovah Shalom, the God of peace. Because, oh God, you are who you are. You've summoned us this morning into your presence to stand before you in praise and magnify you and lift you up. God, we thank you for those who are going through their go-through today. We pray, oh God, that you would just overshadow them with your love, your peace, and your grace. Let them know, oh God, that you're simply a prayer away. God, we thank you for this day. In the midst of all that is going on, we pray, oh God, for the Floyd family. We pray, oh God, for our cities across this nation. We pray, oh God, for peace that surpasses all understanding. And we know, oh God, that in the end, we're going to win because we'll do it through you, our Lord and Savior. God, we send the prayers for those who are sick and shut in. We send the prayers, oh God, for those who are unemployed. We send the prayers this morning, oh God, for those who are going through crises within their own homes, knowing that you'll make a way somehow. So God, we thank you today. We lift you up. Holy Spirit, you're already here, always welcome. Have your way in all that we say. Have your way in all that we do. Have your way in our walk and our talk and our singing and our giving and our preaching and our praise. Holy Spirit, have your way on this day. We say this prayer in the mighty and matchless name of your Son, Jesus the Christ, with thanksgiving. Preach per se, but we're we're going to talk to you a little bit this morning. Because folks need to hear. They need to hear from heaven. And they need to hear and have an understanding of what's going on and the trick of the enemy. Amen. The trick of the enemy. So we got a lot to do in a condensed period of time this morning. Let's start off by saying we're sending up our prayers to Sister Angela Pugh, wife of Big Mike. Big Mike is home, everybody. Shout out to Big Mike being home. Big Mike is home and recovering. God is awesome. Look where he's brought him from. But we send up our prayers this morning, not only for Big Mike, but we send up our prayers for Angela, his beautiful wife. Her brother transitioned a few days ago. Her brother's name is Michael Boyd. We are praying for them. Services for Michael Boyd will be at the Congo Legacy Center, located at 501 West 28th Street in Wilmington, Delaware. Angela is a member of this church, and so we'll be there providing a word of encouragement, a word of remembrance on behalf of her and the family. So once again, give Mike a call, give Angela a call, let them know that we're praying for them, that we're concerned about them.
Jackie.
I don't know why I'm saying Angela. That's why you're there, you know. And I wrote Angela, Jackie. Thank you, Reverend. I'm sorry, Jackie Pugh. I don't know where Angela, I know where Angela came from. Jackie. Blame it on the heart. I mean, on the head, not the heart. It's been a long week. Jackie, we're praying. Y'all give Jack a call. Jackie, call and let her know that you're praying for her, that you care. Amen.
Amen.
Jackie Pugh. Amen. Amen. Also, a good friend of mine has transitioned at the age of 89, Mr. Benny Wright. Mr. Benny Wright is going home to be with the Lord, and we're praying for the Wright family and asking that God would just be with them. My mother and my father have forsaken me, and that's when the Lord will take me up. So we're praying for the Wright family. And when their services are available, we'll let you know. Praying for Sister Cora Maya, her brother is ill. And we're asking that you pray for Sister Cora and her brother. Prayer changes things. Prayer changes situations. Prayer even changes people. So we're praying. We're praying for them. We're praying. Praying for Deacon Bates. We're praying for Mama Benzina. We're praying for Miss Philomena. We're praying for Brother Frank Leopard. Praying for Brother Deacon Eddie Bell. And praying for Deacon Kennedy. Praying for Reverend Chin and Brother Chin. We're praying for Minister Ethel McCready Johnson's family. We're praying for Antoine, as well as Miss Pat. We're praying for Sister Jean. We're praying for Mom Cole. We're praying for Sister Wing. Praying for Pastor Starks and the Starks family. Praying for Sister Jessie Johnson. Praying for Miss Core. Praying for every member of Community Baptist Church and beyond. Send in your prayer requests. Let somebody know that we are praying for you. We thank God for you. Now, on a little lighter note, I want folks to know that testing virus, the pandemic, the corona virus, will be made available at City Hall. I'm not sure of the date. I think it's the 27th of this month. I will make definite on that by next Sunday, but I think it's the 27th. You'll hear more about that. The testing will be done just like it was down at the local 413, the Union Hall. It'll be made available to our residents once again at City Hall. Please, 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 if you can, come on through. Get your test to see if you are positive or negative. Either way, you can be able to govern your life in a manner that keeps you healthy or makes you healthier. Amen. And so we want you to make sure you be there. That's going to probably start promptly at 10 o'clock in the a.m. Get there early so you might have an opportunity to be tested. Also, our food distribution for the city will be held on Tuesday, beginning at 11 o'clock. Not this Tuesday, because this Tuesday is election time. So don't forget, get out there and vote. Don't forget, I don't tell you who to vote for. I'll just be wearing a mask that tells you who to vote for. Amen. Amen. When the righteous rule, the people are happy. But when the wicked are in power, those who would use mean-spiritedness and nastiness are in place. The people mourn. Amen. Amen. So don't forget. I want to give a shout out to my daughter in the ministry who has been doing an awesome job in the distribution of food. Reverend Rashida Lee, keep doing what you're doing, young lady. Keep feeding the masses. Amen. Keep feeding the masses. Keep lifting up the word of God. We're grateful today. Now, GIVETOCBC. Once again, our hashtag is the dollar sign GIVETOCBC. Also, you may now give using PayPal. As we said before, just go to our website www.cbcchester.org/give. That's www.cbcchester.org/give. Both options are there. Now, once again, you can also go back to your YouTube channel. CBC now has a YouTube channel. All the services since the quarantine are made available. Go back. And I always tell people spaghetti is better the second time around. Amen. Don't forget our Bible studies that are conducted by our very own Reverend Sherrod Graham every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. Join him. Let us know in the comments if you would like to join him. We'll post the link so that you may do so. That's every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. with our own Reverend Sherrod Graham. Now, I was blessed. I got a call from my sister talking to me about the stimulus checks coming. And she got hers. And she said, my brother got his. So I told my wife to look in the mail to see if I was there. Lo and behold, stimulus check came Saturday morning. Somebody say, praise God for the stimulus check. And so therefore, I got my stimulus check and I wrote my tithe for that stimulus check. If you got those stimulus checks, don't forget your tithes. Amen. And or offering. I want to make sure I brought my with me this morning so I can encourage and inspire others to do likewise. Come on, y'all. Give God some praise. Give God some praise. You want to spend that money every day to pay yourself. You might as well spend some of it in the house of prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Let's go to the anointing. Anoint my mind.
Anoint my mind.
So that I may be in perfect peace.
So that I might be in perfect peace.
Anoint my tongue.
Anoint my tongue.
So that the words of my mouth.
So that the words of my mouth.
Will be acceptable unto you.
Will be acceptable unto you.
Anoint my heart.
Anoint my heart.
So that it might be clean.
So that it might be clean.
Anoint my hands.
Anoint my hands.
So that I might serve you.
So that I might serve you.
And anoint my feet.
So that my footsteps
will
always
be ordered by you.
Be ordered by you.
Amen, amen, amen. The anointing, the anointing, the anointing makes the difference. I am not going to, before I get to July the 5th, write that down in your hearts and in your minds, July the 5th will be Community Baptist Church Independence Day. This is when we will start the process, slowly and properly, coming back to the house of prayer, with some changes in our order of service and the way we handle our service. I'll be meeting with our ushers. Matter of fact, I'm going to talk to the head of president of the Ushers Union here in the city of Chester to try and work out plans with even other churches, simply because the ushers are going to play a more than vital role in this process. You know how folks, usher walks in front of them and tries to lead them to their chair and the person peel off and go someplace else. Well, if you peel off, you'll be walking out the door. Let me say it again. You peel off, you'll be walking out the door. The ushers are going to play an extremely vital role as we prepare to slowly but surely come back to the house and pray. We'll first make sure that this church is fully sanitized. Ushers will direct you to your seat. We will social distance. We will wear a mask in the house of prayer. By that time, I will have a plastic shielding. I'm going to talk to Deacon Kennedy right here. Fiberglass, plastic, whatever they call them, one of those shields up here. We'll make sure that sanitizer is made available. If you don't have a mask, we have masks available for you. Now here we are. Watch this. I'm asking those persons who are 65 and under who would like to be a part of the worship experience to come. You know your own condition. You know your family's condition. You know your own apprehensions. You be led by them. those who are willing, who want to be here, we're going to open up the doors, and you will be socially distanced. I'm trying to, some folks will say, well, why not older folks? Because we're being very protective of our elders. This thing is not over yet. And so we're going to be very protective of our elders. I know some of you probably saying, I'm coming anyway. Please, your Independence Day is in August. Amen? August. We're gonna get through this, even if it means talking about two services. Our services will be shortened. Won't be a whole lot of hugging, kissing, as usual. We gotta get through this, y'all. We want to be wise. We want to use some wisdom as we worship God. Amen?
Amen.
So Independence Day, July the 5th, we're going to wait on the Lord. We're going to wear our finest mask. Our finest mask. We're going to be ready to worship in our finest mask. The numbers will be limited as we worship. The social distance and the ushers will be in charge. I want to talk to my president, my very own president, Sister Gladys. I'm going to talk to her. We're going to work it out. We got time. Tell somebody we got time. So we want to make sure that we do this and do this right. Amen. We're getting back to the house of prayer slowly. But surely, my praise team will be here. My preachers will be here. And you'll be here. Amen? And then we'll work on the rest of the first Sunday in August. We won't be doing Sunday school at this time because we'll be shortening the service so that folks can get in. They praise on it and then get back to their home safe and sound. Amen. Now, the word of God for the people of God. You have, and I'm just going to be short this morning. I got two pieces of scripture. Proverbs 29:2 reads this manner. It says, an angry man stirs up strife, and a hot-tempered man abounds in transgressions. Ephesians 4:26 says, be angry, and yet do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. I want to just talk about peace. Peace. You see what is going on in the world today. George, is it Floyd? George Floyd. And then this young nurse, technician, Brianna, I think I got her name right. They lost their lives at the hands of those who were called to protect and serve. And it's nothing new at all. But it's something that has to be addressed, and it has to be addressed now. But it has to be addressed in the right way. I've gotten calls already, and there were some who had planned to come and march on Chester, as if we don't have our own issues. What those officers did was wrong, terribly wrong, and should pay for that wrong. Every last one of them. But vengeance is not ours. God reminds us that vengeance belongs totally to Him. And see, when we let go and let God, God has a way of turning things around for our good and not for our bad, not for our destruction. I told somebody, and I got him back there, and I meant to bring him. 45 years ago, in this city, watch this, God has a way of turning things around. Darren, could you? There's an envelope right by my desk on my left hand side, has x-rays in it. 45 years ago, a buddy of mine, we're hanging out. 45 years ago, I double parked at 5th and Lloyd Streets. 45 years ago, about 10:30, friend of mine, we were gonna hang out. We stopped at my girlfriend's house at that time. I wanted to tell her something that was going to go about our business. And I double parked. Thank you. In doing so, the police pulled up behind my car. And I told the young lady, I said, I gotta go. I'm about to get a ticket. And I rushed back to the car. And as I get back to my car, the police officer says, I should give you a ticket. Then he called me the N-word. Now, these were two black police officers. And I said, wow. All this over double parking. I said, I'm gonna move. And he said, I should still give you a ticket. I said, well, and I'm jokingly saying, well, what's the ticket? $25 back then. 45 years ago. And so I got into my car and I proceeded to back up and I saw the police officer step behind my car. I said, what's he doing back there? And then he drops. And I looked at my friend, I said, something crazy is about to happen. I never touched him. 45 years ago, they arrested me, put the handcuffs on me, put me in the back seat of the car, and I simply told my friend and my lady friend, I said, I need you to call my mom to let my mom know that they're taking me over to the police station. And so as we were getting ready to pull up, my buddy knew one of the police officers, and he said to him, you know, man, come on, man, you wouldn't do this if you was round down projects, which enraged the officer. Now, both of the officers were intoxicated, needless to say. He enraged the officer so much with that comment that the officer took off after him. And I'm in the back seat of the car saying, this is crazy. What's going on? Next thing I heard is two shots. And I'm saying to myself and to the officer, you're doing this for double parking? You're shooting for double parking? Well, I'm in the back seat of the car and the other officer drives around and we see my buddy in the alley with his hands up saying, okay, okay. The officer runs up on him and hits him in the head and splits his head wide open with the butt of the gun. I remember it 45 years ago. They throw my buddy back in the car. He's bleeding all over me. I'm just hysterical now. I'm like, I don't believe you guys did this. What is going on? What, are you guys serious? And they say, we're going to show you how serious we are. 45 years ago, they drove us to the back of the police station, located this time, the old police station that was located right in front of City Hall. They pulled me out of the car. They beat me so severely, I knew that I was going to die that night. I remember them knocking me out to the middle of the street and they stood back waiting for me to run. And I said, God, if I run, they're going to shoot me in the back. So I ran into the police station as if that was a good idea. I can laugh about it now. I've never been beaten that severely and that badly before in my life by anyone. My arms were four times the size they are because I was blocking the sticks from hitting me in the face. My back has never been the same. 45 years ago. Hard to see them now. I kept every x-ray. Every single x-ray. Watch this. I was 20 years old. 45 years ago. I kept every single x-ray. I forgave them gentlemen, those men, many, many moons ago. But isn't this something, isn't it ironic how God has now placed me in a position where I am over law enforcement in the city of Chester. And I look out that back, I look out my window every day to that same street that I was brutally beaten in. Why do you say all this, Pastor? I say all this to say this. Some things may never change. Sometimes things will get worse before they get better. But it's up to the individuals to do what they know is right in their heart. If a man breaks into your house and does some damage to your house, do you come home to your house afterwards, see the damage, and get so upset that you burn down your own house? That makes no sense. That makes no sense. There are things that we have to do as a society and as a people. Yes, bring them to justice. Yes, make them pay the price. But no, no, no. Don't allow your good deeds to be infiltrated by those negative attitudes and wishes and wills of demonic people. There are some folks that take advantage of a situation to come in and to destroy and tear up a community just because they can. They take advantage of your emotions and your hurt. It's okay. It was okay for me to be angry. But it would not be okay for me to go around, turn around, and do the same to somebody else. Because I am my brother's keeper. I am my sister's keeper. Stand for justice. Stand for righteousness. Stand for peace. And call on the name of the Lord. And I guarantee you, he still fixing it. I watch so much stuff on the news, and it's just heartbreaking. Now you got activists angry with mayors and politicians, and you got folks that are blaming one another. Because folks don't know how to come together. We're a unique church, as you can see. We are different. We don't agree on everything, but we do know that God is here. We do know what the Word of God says, come let us reason together, how to work things through and work things out without destroying one another. One thing for certain, and two things for sure. You can't run away from the justice of God. You can't run away from the vengeance of God. You can't run away from the courthouse of God. And I tell folks, while we're at it, while we're fighting the good fight for those persons whose lives were lost at the hands of law enforcement. Because let me tell you something, there are a few bad apples in everything that we do, in everything that we are. And there are a bunch of great people, good people, mixed in with those bad apples. And while we're at it, while we're fighting for justice, let's look at ourselves here in this city and say, how much longer are we going to keep killing one another? How much longer are we going to watch our babies die and watch our babies have guns placed in their hands? And how much longer are we going to be afraid of our own children? Come on. Yeah. We can walk and chew chewing gum at the same time. Those are the marches I want to see here. When do we march for these young people and say enough is enough? When are we going to stop studying war? Put down those guns and pick up a tool that helps you build your life and a community. An angry man stirs up strife. They're the ones that you can't even talk to. The ones that are screaming in your face, but with no answers, no solutions. An angry man. A hot-tempered man abounds in transgression. They got their own mess, and they're trying to cover up for themselves by using you to destroy you and your very own community. It's okay to be upset about what's going on, and you should be. But don't hurt other people. Don't tear up your community. Because guess what? If you kill somebody, then you going to jail, and God got to deal with you. You burn down somebody's building, then you're going to jail. They got cameras out here. I don't know what these people are thinking about. You burn up a police car, you don't think they have cameras and everything else? Use some wisdom. And one of these days, you want to learn how to transform a community, then you become what they are not. You become those persons who are willing to protect and serve and stick and stay in your very own community. Peace. And not just any peace, but we need a peace that surpasses all understanding. So today, I challenge Chester to be that shining star throughout this nation to show folk how it's done right. To show folk that we can live in peace and harmony, one with another. To show folk that truly I am my brother's keeper. I am my sister's keeper. A peace that surpasses all understanding. Our Father, our God, we thank you. We thank you for this moment in time. We thank you for the opportunity to speak peace. Thank you for the opportunity to speak truth to life. God, your people are hurting even right now, but we know, oh God, without a shadow of a doubt, that if you would just speak a word, lives will be changed for the better. So God, right now, you touch them. Touch them. Those young ones that don't know you, God, just grab them up right now and put them close to your bosom. They're hurting, oh God, but all they need to understand is that you are our Father. Yes, you are. And you will withhold no good thing from them. So God, you bless them right now. You calm their spirits. You take away their fears and their frustration. And God, you replace them with wisdom and understanding to do the things that are pleasing within your eyes. Remind them, oh God, that you are the true and only judge. That vengeance belongs completely and totally to you. And God, you'll fix it in your time. We say this prayer in the mighty and matchless name of your Son, Jesus the Christ. With thanksgiving, our soul says, amen, amen, amen. We give God honor, we give God praise. We want you to know at home that if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, you can get to know him right now. Just come unto me, just as you are. Come unto me, all who are sick and heavy laden. He said, I will give you rest. Come to him. Just as you are. He said, I stand at your door, the door of your heart, and I knock. And if you open up, wow, just think of all those young people, those angry young people who are out there today. If they would answer that door, wow. Be life-changing. I challenge you to open the door of your heart. Allow him to come in and sup with you. Allow him to come in and give you rest, give you peace, give you joy, give you love, give you understanding, so that you might have a fruitful and abundant life. So today, just as you are, I dare you to surrender to him, just as you are. Amen. Amen. Keep reading that. Ephesians 4:26 and Proverbs 29:22. Keep reading that as we go through. Amen. Keep reading that. God bless you. We love you. Praise team. Thank you for an awesome worship. know they could sing like that, did y'all? We had something special for y'all when they come back. I'm telling you now. Amen. Thank you, Brother Darren. Thank you, Bishop. Thank you, Miss Nadine and Miss Tyler, Miss Sharita. We thank God for all of you. Most of all, we thank you, our technician, Reverend Sherrod Graham, the leader of the Graham Crackers. Amen. God bless you all. Sister Lima, we're still praying for you. Godspeed and your recovery. And anybody else that I missed, Sister Jackie, I'll be calling you today as we move forward in the going home services of your brother. What a mighty God we serve. Yep, don't forget communion. This Saturday, drive by and get your communion this Saturday so that we might commune with you on Sunday morning. Amen. 12 to 2. Not 2:30. 12 to 2. Amen. Amen. Father God, we thank you for this moment in time. We thank you for this opportunity to break the bread of life. God, we ask, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that you would continue to protect us and guide us and deliver us, oh God. God, we ask that you would even save us from our sins. Now, oh God, as we prepare to leave this place and go to the next, we pray, oh God, that you keep your angels camped round about us. Protect us from all hurt, harm, and danger. And as we arrive at our destination, oh God, we'll find our houses and our homes in better shape than they were when we left. Now, oh God, may your grace, in the love of Jesus Christ, sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide within us, henceforth and forevermore. Let the children, the church of the living God, say amen, amen, amen. Be blessed.